Hello everybody, welcome to this tutorial of how to turn your Raspberry Pi into a PLC. I will show you a quick setup of what you're going to be able to do at the very end of this video, if you have the same setup at least. You can control the Raspberry Pi with anything that has a web browser on it, so well as a laptop or a mobile phone. So this is to show you this setup real quick. Alright, first of all, let's start with downloading Codasys. So you go to the Codasys website, there you can go to downloads. Then a little down below you will find download center, you click on the arrow. If you've done that, a new tab will open and there you can actually download Codasys. You need to log in, so you need to create an account. As soon as you've done that, you will be able to download Codasys 3.5. If you've done that, you go to the store, here it is, and type in Raspberry or Rasp or whatever. You'll find a Raspberry plugin. You need to download that one as well, but remember guys, for this you actually need a purchase account as well. So that's something else than the account you made in the first bit. Down below you will find some things about the Codasys plugin, some manuals, some specs of what it is able to do. Alright, when you've done that, you already start up Codasys, or not, however you like, and see if it's already running. Then we go to the Raspberry Pi right now. Guys, I actually recommend installing Raspbian on your Raspberry Pi with Noobs. If you haven't done that, I'm going to show you the way to expand your files as well. If you have used Noobs, you can actually skip that part, because if you've done it by Noobs, it's already expanded the files. But we will come to that later on. So, starting up the remote server. So this is my Raspberry Pi. Alright, here you can see your IP address on the Raspberry Pi. If you just go with your mouse on that, it will show you. Now go to menu. Yeah, I got in Dutch actually, so I do not know what it is in English, probably preferences. And there you can find Raspberry configuration, and there you can find file expand at the top. You can do it like this, or you can go to the terminal and there you can type in sudo space resp config. With this you open up the configuration window of Raspbian. Here you see file expand. You can actually click that if you still need to do that. What you can do as well, you can go to advanced options. There are some few options you can actually go through, see what they are. I2C connection, serial connection. Yeah, it's real nice. Host name. You can change your host name here as well if you want to. Right, so that was that. Then we go back to Codasys. So Codasys should be still up, or in my case, it's still up. You go to Tools, Package Manager. There you see the Raspberry Pi package that you need to install. So then you press on install and it will run it. I've already installed it, so it's not really necessary anymore. And after that you go back to tools again and you go to update Raspberry Pi. Now with this you need to fill in your IP address and your password of your Raspberry Pi and your hostname, and that will actually already make connection with your Raspberry Pi. If you've done everything correctly, you should see update finished at the bottom. All right, now you can go to new project. Be sure that the standard project is selected. Now give it a name. I just give it a random name, like I do for all my projects. And now it starts to run. I got a certain pop-up message, but that's because I've already made one with that name. Of course I did. Here you can actually select on what device you want to do it. So we choose the Raspberry Pi. In my case, down below, you will see certain program languages you can use. I use Ladder, but you can use script language, function blocks, whatever you're comfortable with. Structural text is even possible. So you press on OK, and now it will load everything in. So now it will load in the PLC PRG thing. You actually need that to run a certain program. It's like if you're familiar with Siemens, it's your OB. Right, so I'm going to program in this. Just put a lamp on switch. So this is going to be a button. Yeah, button is just a boolean where you can see bool. You can actually change it into an integer or whatever you like. Click on OK. On the down below, you saw a description. You can add description if you want that as well. This is going to be a lamp stat. So this is, and it's a set coil. So with this, I'm going to set the variable to a certain, in this case, in boolean to 1 or to a high, whatever you want to call it, to a true. And now a lamp off button, and this will this is a boolean as well. So, and now put a reset coil on it, and now I'm going to show you how to get to, if you click next to it, you can go to this window, and here you can select all your variables. In this case, I'll select my variable lamp stat, so it will reset it. All right, so that's a small program we're gonna run. Now we're gonna go to application, add object, and then select visualization. I always activate the symbols as well. All right, then it starts to load. All right, so now here we have our visualization manager and our web browser. You can see that as well. First of all, let us make a button. So I drag this button or the lamp here. Sorry, it's a lamp. And down below, you can actually set its color. It's, normally it's on yellow. I'm going to turn it to green. I like the green much more. Then I put my variable in. I just click on the right thingy again. Go to application. Go to the program. The variable's in. And then I'm going to select the variable. In this case, lamp stat. All right, now the variable is in. Now we can start creating buttons. Damn, that's my phone. So I'm gonna create my buttons completely on me on myself. That's more fun. You got more stuff you can do with it. Here you can see you can use two colors, so it will slightly bend into the other color, blend into the other color. You can use one color as well. You can see it right down below. You can actually select that. I started for the hard way. I'll have to make it hard on myself so I can spend more time on it. Press on OK again. And give it a name. So just give it a name. And you have to select the fact that you're going to use that color. Okay, you can make a color change as well. A real handy something of this program, you can just control copy, control paste, and then it will copy it with all the settings it's in. So I'm gonna name this one off. I'm gonna change its color, of course. I'm gonna do it the hard way again. So this one's gonna be red. It's gonna turn the light off. All right, so that was that already. Oh wait, we need to put in variables still. I've done this the wrong way the first time. Sorry for that, guys. But you go into input configuration, and there you select variable in tab, not in toggle, but in tab. And when you've done that for all of to the buttons, you go to web visualization, the top visualization. You see the visualization page. You're actually gonna load. We just have one, so it's not gonna be a problem. And the button down that, it's gonna be web fusion. That's how it's called. And I always put in on. Yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, then you go to your IOs, GPIOs. You see them next. And first, you go to the parameters, and then you're gonna set the GPIO you're gonna use to input or output. In our case, an output. So then you go to GPIO mapping, then you search for the same GPIO. In my case, I had 25, so I go down to 25, bit 25. And I'm going to set a variable to it, and that's going to be the lamp stat. So now lamp stat goes on, and it will actually switch GPIO 25 on. After that, you go to device in the top, you're gonna search for network. It's gonna be in the top as well. Scan for network, and there you're gonna select your Raspberry Pi, and then you go to the top to login, and then you press yes. Oh wait, in my case I had the wrong device selected, and why I did that, oh yeah, it's automatically selects your computer, so go to scan networks, select the Raspberry Pi, and then gonna do a login again. In my case there's already programmed in the Raspberry Pi, so that's why I have that pop-up screen, but otherwise you won't have that. So now it's putting the program into the Raspberry Pi. Now we're gonna see what's happening. Alright, yeah, so now it's stop, like a PLC, put it in a run mode, in this case start. By left clicking on it, you got start option. And now it's running, so now I should be able to approach it with my web browser. So you type in the IP address, then you type in the port number, and normally it's 8080, and then the name of it, and in my case it was WebFreezer, and you see the button going on, and in the back you see actually the light turning on. Now I'm going to do that with my phone as well. I am just starting internet, and here you see it, so you can make it smaller, you can adapt it. And now you see when I turn the button on, it will turn on. If I turn the button off, it will turn off. So this is how easy it actually is. Soon I'm going to make some more videos. I'm going to assure you the quality of the video is going to be better. Until then, have a nice programming and good luck.